I think the focus on Massachusetts could be effective. I'm just not sure about the execution yesterday. And then the hecklers were fed into later by Mitt Romney himself. Axelrod's remarks were drowned out, as you could see, when we showed you the soundbite, and now this rally. Romney, later in the day, came to the heckler's defense. Take a listen.
Most of the events I go to, or many of the events I go to, they're large groups of, if you will, Obama supporters there heckling me. And at some point you say, you know what, sauce for the goose is sauce for the gander. If they're going to be heckling us, why, we're not going to sit back and play by very different rules. If the president's going to have his people coming to my rallies and heckling, why, we'll show them that, you know, we conservatives have the same kind of a capacity he does.
So they sent them in, sent people
that
in to scream at David Axelrod.
If I
Are you kidding me?
Somebody else's rally? Be talking about it on
That's incredible. That's kind of rude and childish, actually.
I am stunned. I'm stunned.
With all due respect.
You want some plausible
that
deniability.
You want plausible deniability.
Come on,
man.
Oh, my God.
Ed Rendell, I'm not going to even ask what you've done in your political career. I'm not going to even ask. I don't want to know. But if you did,
So
they sent people there to scream at David Axelrod?
You wouldn't brag about it, would you? Oh, come on, Meekin.
And plus the fact,
Democrats do that all the time.
No, they're not stupid enough to talk about it, obviously.
Well, exactly. Bingo.
But
I still think
that a good public speaker can take protesters, play off them, and hit it out of the park.
Yeah.
It happens all the time. Part of the book I say, and one of the things politicians wuss out on, is not showing up at events when there's going to be hecklers. Eric Cantor, he bills himself as a young gun, and he's an awfully bright, smart guy. He backed away from an appearance at Penn when he heard that some of the occupiers might be in the audience. Well, if I'm Eric Cantor, as smart as he is, I would have taken those occupiers and twisted them into pretzels.
Yeah.
You know, and that's what it's all about. I mean, people hate people who try to drown out others.
That is.
Yeah. They do.
Coming up, former presidential candidate Buddy Roper. That was just.
I cannot believe that he would just go out and say, yeah, we
I'm going to send teams people to scream.
What year did that come from? What sauce?
53.
Is that 53?
Nanny Poo.
Good year.
Because isn't that
sort of the Rambo came on the market?
Yeah. He didn't say good for the goose.
I know.
Sauce for the goose. Well, it comes in those little tea trays and they ladle it out.
No, I understand.
You've had sauce, really.
I understand that. He says what sauce
you don't hear it a lot.
You don't
hear it a lot.
I don't think, though, in today's people to scream.
Yeah.
It's not. I think there's actually a more serious conversation why you don't do that.
But it's done.
Okay. In this climate, I wouldn't do that.
Try to give a speech as a conservative in certain places where there's heavy union membership, and then come talk to me about being shocked and stunned and deeply saddened that Republicans.
This isn't the Dartmouth Review back in the 80s. Okay. Like a bunch of college kids thinking they're being political. It's not cool.
What are you saying, man? What?
I don't think it's a good idea on a number of really serious levels to be doing that. Would you like to go there?
It's not a good thing to admit it.
Would you like to go there?
Go where?
About why that would be a very bad idea to send people into an audience to start screaming at someone who's at the podium.
I think it's stupid to do that.
Are you all stupid, or do you just not want to have this conversation?
I just don't think this is the worst thing in the world. It's bad, but I wouldn't talk about it for the next 10 minutes. I'm a little more concerned about what's going on in Syria.
Yeah.
Than a couple of morons with signs.
Yeah.